Dollar Dining in Nebraska. Today we are heading to
the Big Pig.
I forgot the name. And where is it parked?
The Big Pig is currently parked in front of the Antique Mall on South Burlington, same kind of area as KFC in Hastings, Nebraska.
There you go. Let's see, it's a cloudy day out. I don't know, I mentioned the weather last time, so it's a cloudy day out today. And we're heading out there, and we're going to try the fish tacos. Are you having something different than that?
I am. It's called the Big Pig, and so it's a barbecue truck primarily. But they also have a fish taco special today that Esther can try, since she doesn't eat pork or beef, so it should be good. Or chicken.
Yeah.
Right.
Okay, see you guys soon. Okay, so what is your name?
Amy Schneezy.
Why did you decide to open this place or work here?
Well, it was a dream of Matt's, so, you know, I just followed along, and we're having a great time. It's been a learning experience, but good. It gives us a little more time with our family, so, yeah, I'm enjoying it.
What's your favorite item on the menu?
Probably the Loaded Mac.
The Loaded Mac.
The Loaded Mac.
And do you get that with the pulled pork or the pulled chicken?
With the chicken.
Okay.
I'm a fan of the chicken.
Chicken is better than pork.
It has a little hint of maple, and I mean, that's...
Now, is that because you're Canadian?
Maybe.
Do you have any questions?
No, but you want to talk about that? Is he busy?
Yes. Okay, so what is your name?
I'm Matt Schneezy.
And why did you decide to open this place?
So when I worked in the oil fields in North Dakota, I lived in a town the size of Juniata with 60,000 people, and there was no food. Food truck started showing up, and I was like, we really got to experience a lot of different good foods. And I said, man, I can do that someday. And when we moved home, I got a job at Odyssey, started cooking down there, and slowly but surely kind of kept chasing this. A year ago, the Big Pig came up for sale. I'd had their food before, I liked the concept, so we bought it, and we've taken that concept and kind of ran with it our own way. Midwest and Nebraska, well, pork is kind of everywhere. So instead of trying to make our meat unique, all of our sauces are kind of our style, adds to it, builds on it. And then we got a lot of requests for ribs, and I spent 6 months working on a home blend. It's very unique in this area. And then we had to master the art of keeping ribs hot, moist, and not overcooked for a 12-hour window. That took 6 months or so. We kicked them off right before we closed last year, and this year they've become our number one seller. So we sell out basically every day on ribs.
So what is your favorite food though?
The pig slop. It is a bed of potato salad, little pork, little chicken, style you want on top. It's just kind of a little of everything. When you work in here all day, every day, you get inventive because it's a little change. That was something that I was just eating every day, so put it on the menu.
Nice.
Okay.
Anything else? Okay.
Cool.
Have a great day.
Thanks for coming.
Hello. We just got our food. If you want to review first, I'm going to get the fix out of these.
All right. Well, I got the ribs. And they sell the ribs by bone. And I got 4 bones, and that's going to be quite a lot of meat. And then they have different sauces that they make there. We heard him talk about the sauces, which is like a napkin, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So I'm excited to try the sauces. And then I also got all their sides. And I did that for 2 reasons. 1, to try them and tell you about them. And 2, because Jessica, my wife, her mom, loves sides when she goes to barbecue restaurants. And so we got their house-made slaw. We got their potato salad. And then we also have the, he makes kimchi, which is pickled cabbage. And so we'll try all these.
And he gets to start while I grab water. I use the water glass as a phone stand and did not grab water.
All right. I'm gonna try the ribs here first without any sauce, just try the meat. And it is delicious. The meat falls right off the bone. It's tender, it's perfectly seasoned, it's not too salty. It's smoky, it's just right. One of the things I've always lamented is we don't have a barbecue restaurant that serves ribs here in Hastings. We now have a couple barbecue food trucks, including this one, so I'm excited to be able to get good ribs. So how was that first bite of the taco, kiddo?
It was mostly coleslaw. Okay. I didn't take a giant bite, okay. So I just kind of got a mouthful of coleslaw. I got the fish this time.
What do you think?
The coleslaw has a bit of sweetness to it.
Okay.
I think it's like cabbage or something. Mm-hmm. Has a bit of sweetness to it. Is this the cheese? Yeah, it's probably cheese. The cheese is good, and the fish. I mean, it's a white fish.
Cod.
Yeah, it's cod. You don't really taste much of it, but it's good. I like it.
Well cooked.
Yes, I'll give it 8.5.
8.5 out of 10. All right. You want to try the coleslaw? Oh, yeah, I guess you have a slaw in your thing. Mm-hmm. You want to try the potato salad?
Sure.
All right.
I don't usually eat potato salad, so this will be...
Here you go.
It always seems wrong to have cold potatoes. They should be like... I mean, like, even chips are room temperature. I'm not a big fan of potato salad, so I wouldn't be a great judge.
Okay. Well, I'd say it's an excellent potato salad. And I'm going to try the kimchi now, which I'm very excited about. Kimchi is pickled cabbage. It's a Korean dish. And they said they've made this for the Nebraska palate, so we'll give it a shot here. That is delicious. It's a flavor that we don't often get here in Nebraska, and it's really good. A little bit spicy and crunchy. The cabbage is still crunchy. It's got a nice tang to it. It's delicious. So I'm very impressed with the kimchi. It's all a good meal.
Is that it?
I think so.
You wanted to review the coleslaw?
Oh, sure. Excellent coleslaw. Good stuff.
Okay. Well, see you later. Bye.